Hello everyone, this is Blood Queen Tiro, and I am here to do a reading for I am here to do an after dark reading. So this after dark reading is for the collective. Collective meaning all signs. So my after dark reading hours is from 7 p.m. to 5 a.m. the next day. And today is Wednesday, September the 28th. So for after dark hours for Wednesday, 7 p.m. to 5 a.m. the next day. My time is Eastern Standard Time, so collective, you can apply the reading according to your time zone, or if you have a different time zone than I do. But this is after dark hours tonight, from 7 p.m. to 5 a.m. the next day, Eastern Standard Time. And if you got a different time zone than me, then you know you can apply it according to your time zone. All right, so collective, keep in mind that the reading, it may or may not resonate with you. Some parts of the reading might resonate, other parts of the reading might not. As well, keep in mind that time is fluid, so this reading can manifest after dark hours tonight. It can manifest later on down the line of time. Or this present reading could be past energy for you. If this present after dark reading is past energy for you, then it might be answers or closure for you in this present after dark reading that pertains to your past situation or circumstance. Also, keep in mind that I do my after dark readings a little bit differently concerning when I do a collective after dark reading. When I do a collective after dark reading, collective, it could be your energy or somebody around you. So it doesn't necessarily have to be you. It could be somebody pertaining to you or somebody connected to you. That's how I gear my after dark readings when I do it for the collective. So it might not be your energy I'm picking up on. It could be somebody you're connected to. But your angel answer is your energy, collective. That's how I gear the reading. So the angel answer is your energy. I mean, the angel number is your energy. But anything after that concerning the tarot, it can be somebody else's energy. So just keep that in mind. That's how I do my after dark readings. I don't know why, but that's how I do it. That's how I be led to do my after dark readings. So let me just go ahead and jump in. I didn't get messages during the pre-shuffle, so I'm going to show y'all what's at the bottom of the deck. So we got the Ten of Swords. So somebody could be an air sign. We got ignoring. We have high vibes. High vibrational person, energy that feels good, light, and easy. We have investigating. I didn't even shuffle this deck. I wasn't really planning on using this deck. So, investigating. Let me shuffle it real quick. Let's see what's at the bottom. Yeah, police. Then we have abundance. So somebody is having a good night and somebody else could be going through hell. That's what I'm picking up. Somebody having a good night and somebody else going through hell. And then we have number three, the house. The house denotes success in our ventures. If present condition is unpleasant, the future will be happy and prosperous. This card also predicts marriage. Then we got happy family. Let me shuffle this deck. I forgot to shuffle this deck as well. So let me shuffle this real quick. I just saw hostilities. And we have adjacent possibilities. All right. And then at the bottom of this deck, we got health checkup. Collective, you or somebody else could be a Virgo. I just did Virgo's mid-monthly reading. This came out for Virgo. And then the angels that I am awakening, the angel numbers. The universe is arranging people and experiences on your path to help you succeed and helping you wake up to who you truly are. All right. So, is that all the cards that I'm using after dark hours? All right. So, what's the collective's angel number? So I am inspiring. Number 21, you break that down. That's a 3. So collective, this is your angel number. Number 21 for After Dark Hours tonight. You are inspiring. This is the energy that your angels have you in. You are highly creative with a strong will to succeed. Your imagination is highly charged. It reveals itself in everything you do, from your sparkling conversation to your most prized projects. So collective, I'm picking up, you're being productive after Dark Hours tonight, and collective, somebody else is getting into trouble. That's the energy. I'm picking up like polar opposites, like opposite energy. Somebody's being high vibrational and somebody else is like getting into trouble. Or it could be getting caught by the cops or something. Or somebody's getting karma. So collective, you're inspiring. So this is your overall energy. This is your angel number. You're inspiring and somebody else's. I don't know. Oh my God. No. No. I heard collective, you're inspiring and somebody else is expiring. So collective, I don't know if somebody might pass away after Dark Hours tonight. That's what I just heard. You're inspiring and somebody else is expiring. That's crazy. That, ah, man, I don't like stuff like that. But we did have the Ten of Swords at the bottom of the deck. So let me just go ahead. All right, so what's going on? Collective, After Dark Hours tonight, what's going on? Or what do the collective need to know? What's going on? All right, so we have strategy. Yeah, I don't think that's good. We're going to see. Somebody trying to be slick, it might backfire. And then we got indecision. I just saw indecision. I'm picking up, somebody was planning on doing something after Dark Hours tonight. But either way this person go, they still going to end up in trouble. So say like After Dark Hours tonight, somebody was planning on, this is something premeditated. Say like somebody was planning on robbing somebody. It's like somebody might decide not to rob someone, but this person is going to get robbed. So somebody is like trapped. And they don't realize it. Somebody could be getting karma. Or somebody's trying to stall someone. Somebody could be trying to stall somebody or set somebody up. Somebody has a strategy here. Collective, while you're being inspiring, somebody else is being devious. Somebody being devious. And it's like either way this person go, they're going to get in trouble. So like I said, somebody was planning on doing something premeditated that wasn't right. And say like this person decide not to do it. A robbery. This person is going to get robbed. It's like this person might decide not to do it. But this person that was planning to do something, somebody might offend this person. Or something like that. Yeah, somebody is stuck. I feel it and I see it. Somebody trapped. Oh man. And then we got the mountains nearby indicates the presence of a mighty enemy. Yeah, this could be death. Yeah, somebody, yeah, this is crazy. I don't like this. All right. Give me a message for strategy. Give me a message for strategy. Yeah, number 28, the anchor. Yeah, this could have been a robbery. The anchor denotes successful ventures in business and love. In love. So somebody got a strategy to do something successful in the ventures of love and business. Somebody got a strategy. And it denotes successful ventures in business and love. And then we got number 3 at the bottom of the deck. Collective, I'm picking up for some of y'all. You guys could be engaged to somebody, and your lover is a karmic collective. This person is not who you think they are, collective. Something might happen to somebody's fiance, whether they are male or female. Collective, somebody could have been planning on marrying you for money or using you for like your success or something. But collective, you don't know it. Spirit know it, but you don't know it. Or something shady. Somebody was this is premeditated. Somebody was planning something shady. Yeah, so this can be like somebody marrying somebody for the wrong reason as well. Collective, this could be your fiance or somebody you know, fiance. And somebody's fiance might get karma. Because somebody was like not... Somebody was planning something shady. And this is premeditated. Something is premeditated. I forgot to do this deck right here, but I'm going to do it now. All right, so... Give me three practical energies. Give me three. Practical. That the collective need to be aware of. Someone's being practical, or this is for the collective. Okay, we have set boundaries. So somebody is setting boundaries. Somebody is cooking after dark hours tonight, or should cook. Collective, somebody might... Collective, after dark hours tonight, somebody could have been trying to invite you somewhere. But you're going to tell this person no because you got to cook for something maybe tomorrow. You got to cook or prep for like something. You're prepping, but in the kitchen. Somebody ain't mean somebody no good. And collective, I think what's going to save you is that you're cooking. You have to cook or you're prepping for something around food. And you're going to tell this person, nah, I can't come or I can't do it because I got to cook. And yeah, avoid toxic people. Yup. See? Somebody could have been planning on doing harm to their spouse, their husband, or wife and to collect insurance money or something. And collective, somebody going to tell somebody, nah, I got to cook. And this is going to save somebody's life because they're going to tell somebody, I got to cook or I got to prepare something for tomorrow or something like that. So I'm also picking up somebody could be a business owner and they work in the cooking industry or somebody got a restaurant. Something like that going on. All right, so this is what people or someone is doing practical after their hours tonight. Somebody is setting boundaries. Setting boundaries in your life is a great way to put yourself first. So collective, you and somebody else is setting boundaries. The next energy is cook more. Reduce the urge to eat out and cook more meals at home. Yeah. So that's another thing, another energy. Someone's cooking at home. And then we got avoid toxic people. Hang out with people who will uplift your spirit, not bring it down. Yeah. So somebody could have been wanting somebody to go out to eat, but something was a setup. Or somebody wanted somebody to eat out, but something was a setup. Collective, this could even be somebody's date. Suggesting that you guys go out to eat or something, but something was a setup. Or somebody was going to have somebody robbed, but it was like, it was set up through a date or something like that. Or collective, you or somebody you're dating or somebody else, this person... is only using this person for like financial purposes or something like that. So after dark hours tonight, we have three separate energies, or these three cards could be one person's energy. But what someone is doing practical is setting boundaries. Somebody is setting boundaries in their life, and it's a great way to put themselves first. Another person is reducing the urge to eat out, and they're going to cook more meals at home. Somebody else is avoiding toxic people. Somebody is hanging out with people who will uplift their spirits instead of bring it down. Yeah. Collective, you or somebody else, if somebody feel as though some a lover has an underlying issue, collective, somebody's intuition is correct. Somebody's lover is up to no good. Somebody's lover is up to no good. Or somebody's spouse was planning on doing harm to somebody for like the insurance money or something. Let me get some messages from this deck. Give me some messages for the collective. What do the collective need to know for After Dark Hours? Yeah, somebody doesn't have ancient divine blood. So collective, somebody is probably not as loyal as you think they are. And then a shaman. So collective, somebody doesn't have ancient divine blood. This could be a good thing or a bad thing. I'm picking up it's a bad thing. I'm picking up somebody is not loyal. And collective, you could be a shaman or somebody else is a shaman. So somebody is not loyal. Somebody is like cold-blooded. Somebody is like no good. Somebody no good. They have no loyalty. Somebody is not loyal. And this person could be a shaman or somebody wants to victimize a shaman. Or a shaman wants to victimize somebody. So that's the messages for After Dark Hours tonight from this day. And somebody out here has a strategy on how to get success in ventures of love and business. So collective, somebody could have also been planning on stealing your idea or stealing your work or something. I'm also hearing, I just heard business owners. So people could be targeting business owners or people who is trying to marry entrepreneurs or something like that to come up. Some things like that is going on After Dark Hours tonight. Or somebody might purposefully commit a crime in or around somebody's business to somebody is going to do something on purpose around somebody's business. So it's like somebody could lose customers or something like that. Somebody was planning on doing something to like a business owner or at somebody's place of work. So it's like this person could lose clients and things like that. Or somebody was going to commit a crime at somebody's place of work. And this could have been this person's spouse. Because they wanted, yeah, something like that. Somebody want to take over somebody's business or something. Or run somebody's business while they're deceased. Yeah, then we got the Two of Cups in reverse that just flew out. Yeah, so somebody is not compatible with somebody. And somebody is lying. Somebody is saying that they love somebody and they don't. Somebody is not compatible with somebody. Or somebody don't love themselves. Somebody could just be a hateful person. This person don't love themselves. This person hates successful people. This person hates happy people. People that's motivated, happy, successful. Somebody don't like that. Yeah. So let me go ahead on. So what's going on with the collective? Or what do the collective need to know? A strategy and number 28, the anchor. All right, what's going on? And then we got journal log. So somebody could have been messing up somebody's books or something. Or changing like somebody's name on documents. Something. Just that say a journal log. Or something. Or somebody is watching somebody. Collective, somebody could be watching you. They plan on offending you and they're watching you so they can offend you or be able to take something from you or something. Somebody's keeping a journal or something. And it's a strategy somebody's using. So collective, basically somebody could be watching you or observing you to do harm. To do you harm. Collective, you are inspiring. And whatever you doing, collective, somebody is plotting a strategy to offend you. And this person might pass away after Dark Hours tonight. Or this person is going to have a near-death experience after Dark Hours tonight. So we got the Ten of Swords in reverse. So collective, you or somebody else could be an air sign, dealing with an air sign. You got air in your chart, a Libra, Aquarius, or Gemini. Somebody could have been planning a betrayal, but it's not going to happen. Somebody might get, if somebody passed away, somebody going to get stuck. So somebody is not, like somebody might get stuck in purgatory or somebody, somebody might be on life support or something. Somebody's going to be stuck. Like, but it's like somebody that was planning to do harm to somebody. And somebody might get karma. And this person is going to be stuck. So it's like they can be like on life support. They're not fully gone, but they're gone. Or something like that. Clarify the Ten of Swords in reverse. Yeah, the Knight of Cups. Yeah. Collective, you or somebody else could be a water sign, dealing with a water sign, or got water in a chart, Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpio. Somebody wanted to cause a betrayal through love. The Knight of Cups could be somebody making a romantic gesture, a gesture to somebody. So the Knight of Cups to ask you out on a date, the Knight of Cups to say anything you need, you want me to go get you something to eat, let's go eat out, I'll pay for it. I do it like the Knight of Cups. It's like a sweetheart. Or collective, your lover could have been planning on offending somebody else and it's not going to work. And then your lover going to come your way as if nothing was going on. Clarify the Knight of Cups. Or somebody might change their mind. Somebody might change their mind. They was planning on offending someone, but they might change their mind. But it still could be somebody's lover. And then we got the Star. Yeah. Somebody want to marry somebody for the fame and fortune. Somebody could have been planning on doing harm to somebody, but it's like this person gonna change their mind and they're gonna wait. Somebody is being nice to somebody. Somebody's being generous, but somebody really don't like somebody. They want to betray somebody, but this person is like gonna wait. Or this is somebody that's conceited. The Knight of Cups with the Star. Somebody could be very conceited. Collective, you could be dealing with a very conceited individual. And this person don't like you or something. Or collective, somebody's sleeping with the enemy. Like your lover is like, somebody's lover is planning their demise. Because this person is conceited or they're a narcissist. This person is only getting married for selfish reasons or... this person plan on killing somebody for like insurance money or this person want to take over somebody's business or something. But this person going to wait. Or this is somebody's husband or wife. And they wanted to do this betrayal after Dark Hours tonight, but this person going to change their mind. Somebody could be a narcissist or somebody is like conceited. I also see collective, be careful because you or somebody else, somebody's lover is guilty of murder. This person didn't get caught, but this somebody killed somebody. Somebody did something to somebody and this person hasn't gotten caught. And this person could be a narcissist or they're conceited. Or somebody is like on life support or something. This person is the reason why somebody is on life support. It's like collective, you don't know that your lover did harm to their ex in the past. It's like you don't know that, but your lover is like crazy or something. Somebody only like go after business owners, people that's very inspiring. It's like this person targets successful people. Somebody is targeting, this person targets successful people. But it's like this person, this person don't care. It's like collective, somebody gonna act like they don't care about your fame and fortune, but they do. That's their motivation, your fame and fortune. They trying to say, oh, I love you for who you are. I don't care about that. But this person lying. Somebody probably wanted to poison somebody. Somebody wanted, this could be a poisoning. Because it's like this person is going, it's like the Knight of Cups wants to commit a crime in a particular way. Like this Knight of Cups wants to poison someone, or what the Knight of Cups is going to do is like this person is going to be like in a coma or like on life support. Or something. That's how the Knight of Cups wants something to go. Like, the Knight of Cups wants something to be mysterious. When they offend somebody, they want it to be mysterious. Or not mysterious, but like a mystery. Or something like that. What's going on with the Ten of Swords in reverse? Yeah, the Magician. Yeah, this could be spell work. Yeah, this is dark magic. So this could definitely be somebody putting poison or drugs in somebody's food or drink or something, or poisoning somebody. The Magician, dark magic, and drugs. When a person use drugs like in a illegal way, that's dark magic. So this is a poisoning, and that's considered dark magic. To like poison somebody with the intent to kill them, that's dark magic. I heard anything that's premeditated is dark magic. That's why I just heard that. Anything premeditated is dark magic. It's a form of dark magic. So, or collective, you might, somebody crazy. What's going on with this Knight of Cups? The Eight of Wands. The Knight of Cups probably want to have sex with someone. The Knight of Cups could be traveling to you, collective, or somebody else. Or the Knight of Cups wants some unexpected success. Or the Knight of Cups want some type of fame or fortune that they didn't work for. Mommy. All right, so it's like the Knight of Cups is like going to call somebody and ask somebody, are they hungry or something? Or let's go out to eat. Or let's go out for dinner. Somebody going to tell the Knight of Cups no. And then the Knight of Cups is going to travel to their so-called victim. The Knight of Cups might travel to their so-called victim. But they got to put on a show or put on a front. The Knight of Cups is like being fake. The Knight of Cups want to do harm to somebody. What's going on with the Star? Collective, you could be an Aquarius and you're like unsuspecting. So it's like collective, somebody is thinking about something that you're not thinking about. I just heard the Star is unsuspecting. This Knight of Cups don't care about the Star or something like that. Or the collective, the Knight of Cups wants you to think that they love you for who you are. That's what the Knight of Cups wants you to think. They love you for who you are. It's not your money. It's not your status. Or somebody's lover could be jealous of them. This could be a narcissist. Somebody's lover is jealous of them. What's going on with the Star? Yeah, the Seven of Swords. Yeah. It could be an Aquarius. Collective, you could be an Aquarius, or you got Aquarius in your chart, or you dealing with an Aquarius. The Star is going to get away from something that they need to get away from. Or somebody is lying to somebody. Somebody could be lying to somebody. Yeah. Somebody is feeding somebody old information. So the Knight of Cups probably used to be the Star in the past, but the Knight of Cups is no longer the Star. So the Knight of Cups could be telling somebody a lie. The Knight of Cups can be telling somebody, I'm licensed to do this, I'm licensed to do that, I'm this, I'm that. But this person is lying. Somebody's lying to get their foot in the door. Or this could be somebody saying, I love you for who you are. I don't care about your money. I don't care about your fame and fortune. I love you. Somebody lying. Or the Star is going to get away from that Knight of Cups. Because the Star is either lying, or the Star is going to get away from something or somebody that they need to get away from. On a more positive note, I see, Collective, you're inspiring. If this is your energy, you're very inspiring. You have a strategy here. You're the Magician. Collective, somebody could have been trying to cause you a betrayal. Or, Collective, you could have been nervous. I heard, Collective, you took a risk. And, Collective, whatever type of risk you took is going to turn out in your favor. The Knight of Cups. Collective, you're going to have success. Successful ventures in business and love. So, Collective, you or somebody else could be, Collective, you could be traveling to somebody. You might ask somebody out on a date, Collective. You could be emailing or texting someone. Somebody could be disguising who they really are. Or somebody is being humble about their success. So, Collective, say like you're like a rising star, or you're going to school to become a doctor. You're almost done with school. It's like, Collective, if you a man, you know who you are, your potential, you're very successful, but you want to meet up with this woman, but you're not telling her who you are. You're not telling her you're a doctor or you're a rising star. You're not telling somebody. It's like, Collective, you're the Star, but you disguise yourself, or you're humble or something. Somebody's a star, but they're either humble or, yeah, or something like that. So I just also heard somebody could be a limo driver. I don't know why, but I heard somebody could be a limo driver, or somebody's getting in a limo or something. Then we got the Ten of Wands. Collective, you could be the Magician. What's the spill the beans with strategy in number 28? Yeah, a bugaboo. Yeah. So, somebody is trying to force their way in. Somebody is being very persistent. So, it's somebody's strategy to be a bugaboo, to get their way. And that's how this person plans on getting success in business and love. Somebody's going to be a bugaboo. So somebody's going to keep bugging somebody, begging somebody. Let me be your girlfriend. Let's get married. Let's do this. Let me be your man. Let me do this. Let me be your manager. Let me be your business partner. Somebody plans on being persistent, but somebody's up to something. Somebody's strategy is to be a bugaboo. Or a bugaboo. Collective, this could be your bugaboo. Collective, this could be somebody's ex. Or collective, somebody could have came to you. Collective, somebody could have kept begging you for something. This could be for employment. Collective, this could be for somewhere to stay. Somebody could have been looking for shelter, housing. Collective, somebody was bugging you in the past for something. And you could have denied this person. And collective, somebody could be planning your demise because you rejected them. So the cards could be telling me, collective, a bugaboo has a strategy to like get revenge on you. Because you could have denied them. So it's like, collective, somebody going to figure out a way to get what they want from you. Even if they got to do you harm or something. Collective, if you a man, be careful, because in the past, you had a choice between two. Collective, if you a man, you chose to marry one woman. And your bugaboo got rejected. And collective, it's this woman that you didn't marry. You chose another woman over her. And she's planning like your demise or something. Or somebody's groupie or something is being persistent. Somebody is not giving up. But somebody's intentions is not good. What's the spill with the Ten of Swords with the Magician? What's the spill with that? Yep, see the police, yeah. Yep, the police. Collector, be careful. Because somebody is... the magician wants to manifest. The magician want to do dark magic. This could be to poison somebody. And the collective, that's the beans. The cops is going to have to be called because somebody might go into cardiac arrest or somebody's going to go unconscious. And that Knight of Cups did it. And it could have been a poisoning or something like that. And that's spilling the beans. Or somebody want to leave a dead body at somebody's place of work. And the police is going to have to be called. Somebody going to do something to somebody. So collective, this is what somebody was planning on doing to you, or they just wanted to harm somebody at like around your business and leave this person body there or something. What's the what spill the beans with the Knight of Cups with the Eight of Wands? Somebody wanted to manifest a situation where the cops had to be called, or something's going to happen. This magician, this dark magic. Somebody's going to end up having to call the police because somebody was doing dark magic. Or somebody wanted to fix a situation to where the cops had to be called to a location. And it's somebody's strategy. So collective, be careful because you could have a crazy person. Like your ex or something. And it's like collective, your ex is like going to come to your place of work. And like take a whole bunch of pills and pass out like in front of your business or something. But this woman, collective, somebody better be careful. Collective, you can have like an ex. She's a bugaboo. She can't get over you. This could be a groupie. I see that too. Something, somebody gonna get karma, but it's like they did it to themselves. So collective, say like your ex, this woman, it's like you don't let her come to your home or you don't let her come to your place of work. But this woman, it's like she gonna show up somewhere collective and like try to like kill herself or something. But she wasn't really intending to kill herself, but she might pass away. Like she gonna be in a coma or on life support. Or collective, your ex is really crazy and she was trying to kill herself, but she gonna do it like on your property and do it on purpose. Like something crazy like that. And then we got a private relationship. So, Collective, this could be your third party. Like, this woman is, like, losing her mind. Or this man. Somebody might kill themselves. I also just heard somebody was planning for a murder-suicide, but they're just going to kill themselves. Somebody was premeditated. They was planning for a murder-suicide. That's what this person's intentions was. So, Collective, somebody could have been trying to cause you ruin. Somebody wanted to successfully ruin your successful ventures in business and love. Somebody wanted to ruin your success. So, like I said, Collective, you could be married and your groupie, she crazy, and she wanted to, like, cause the scene at your place of business or something. And it's like, next thing you know, it's like, Collective, you and your wife, it's like somebody got to explain this dead body, this woman. And it's Collective, this woman wanted to cause you and your wife to break up, for you guys to come under public scrutiny or something like that. Something like that going on. A bugaboo. Spill the beans with the Knight of Cups and the Eight of Wands. Yeah, staying centered, aligning yourself with the universe. Collective, you might also call the cops on somebody too. That could be another reason why a betrayal is not going to happen, because you might call the cops. So it's like the Knight of Cups was planning something shady, but the Knight of Cups going to have to hold their composure. Because, Collective, you might call the cops on the Knight of Cups or something like that. I also see, Collective, somebody could be standing outside of your place of work or something. And this is like a business competitor. So it's like, Collective, say like you own like a music studio. It's like the Knight of Cups is standing outside trying to sell his CDs because you wouldn't give him a record deal. So it's like he's standing outside your music studio, people walking by, and he's saying, you want to purchase my CD, this, this, and that. But the Knight of Cups is starting trouble. This bugaboo could be somebody who wanted a record deal. So, Collective, you might call the cops on the Knight of Cups, because it's like a business competitor is around. Or it's like, Collective, you own a restaurant and your business competitor is standing outside of your restaurant passing out flyers. Like, to their business or something. Somebody doing that. But, Collective, it's somebody that you rejected or something. Or somebody that wanted that something. Somebody want revenge. But something is not going to go the Knight of Cups way. And the Knight of Cups is going to have to stay centered and act polite when they really don't want to. Or the Knight of Cups is pretending that they love someone that they don't. So the Knight of Cups is staying centered, aligning themselves with the universe. Because the police or something. Oh, I heard, Collective, the Knight of Cups is only going to be nice to you for a little while longer. That was their plan. Then they was going to show their true colors. That Knight of Cups, I heard the Knight of Cups was planning on being nice to you for a little while longer. What's the spill with the Star and the Seven of Swords? Watching shit go down and enjoying the gossip. Yeah. So, Collective, somebody wanted to offend you. And, Collective, this could be you. Somebody was trying to plan something and it might backfire. And, Collective, you watching shit go down. Watching shit go down and enjoying the gossip. So, Collective, this is crazy. I heard, Collective, for some of y'all, somebody not going to even be able to get to you. Collective, say like you go out after dark hours tonight and you go to like the nightclub or something. And it's like, Collective, when you get out the nightclub, it's like the ambulance and everything is outside. But it's like, Collective, you didn't know that this person was out there waiting for you. Some of y'all is aware and some of y'all not aware that y'all was in danger. And collective, you watching shit go down, enjoying the gossip, not knowing that this person was coming for you or something? Or collective, you could be somewhere with your lover or your spouse and somebody was waiting for y'all to come outside. But collective, something might happen to this person while they're waiting on you to come outside. They was waiting to offend you. But something gonna happen to this person. Collective, you either don't know this person or you don't know this person's motives. If you know this person, I don't think you was aware of their motives. And it's like, collective, you watch your shit go down enjoying the gossip. Like, you had no clue this person got hurt while they was waiting to hurt you. But it's like they're waiting for you outside or something like that. For some of y'all, this person is like a stranger. And this person be watching you. This is crazy. And then we got a situation's about to explode. Shit's about to pop off up in flames. Well, that's what this person wanted. Somebody might also be attempting to like set something on fire, and this person might get caught on fire. And then we got sex. Somebody was trying to be slick, and somebody gonna get karma. Somebody being slick, and they gonna get karma, and then we got a betrayal. Yeah, flew out. Backstabbing, disloyalty. Disloyalty. Doing you wrong, betraying trust. Yep. Somebody was trying to betray somebody. Collective, I also see in the card, somebody did like reverse psychology or projecting. So collective, whoever this person is, this person was going around telling people you a bugaboo. So when they offend you, people wouldn't think it was them who offended you. Because somebody wants, collective, somebody want people to think that they don't know you or they don't care for you or they're not a bugaboo. So when they offend you, collective, it's like this person don't want to be a suspect. So somebody, this could be a lie. Somebody was telling a person or people that you're a bugaboo when it's really them. So this bugaboo could be a lie and it was a strategy. So collective, somebody could have been trying to ruin your character. Somebody could have been trying to ruin your character or your reputation. Or somebody wanted you to lose friends or clients or something. Somebody was doing something. What's the spill with the magician, the ten of swords in reverse, and the police? Yeah, jealous. Lord have mercy. Wants the one you're with. So collective, somebody could have been trying to do harm to you because they want the one you're with. So this could be over music. Somebody wanted your artist. Somebody wanted to steal your artist from you or steal your music or something. Somebody could be bisexual. This is kind of like unsuspecting. This is crazy. Somebody was jealous. Wants the one you're with. This could also be baby daddy, baby mama drama. So collective, be careful. You or somebody else. Somebody was planning on doing harm to their child's mother or child's father because they wanted the child. So this could be custody, like family custody. So just be careful about that, collective. Somebody could either be going through a divorce or you guys are in court over fighting over visitation for the kids or something. And like somebody's ex was planning on doing harm to somebody because they want the child or something. Collective, you and your lover could be in the midst of a divorce. And your lover might call you and say, you know what? Let's call bygones bygones. And collective, your lover, your ex was saying, meet me at the, meet me over here or let's go out to eat. Collective, mm-mm. Your lover was going to do you harm. So somebody could be pretending that they want to make amends, but they were going to do you harm or something like that. What's the spill with the Knight of Cups, the Eight of Wands, and staying centered? Distorted masking here. Abuse of power, force, and domination. Fear of weakness. Competition driven. Inability to praise another. So, collective, this could be a business partner or your ex-lover or soon-to-be ex or something. Somebody dealing with a distorted masculine. And collective, this person is jealous. They want the kids. Or collective, maybe your ex is gay and he like your new lover, or your ex is in love with your new lover or something. Something crazy going on. This distorted masculine could also be a female, but she's in her masculine energy as well. So somebody's ex was up to no good or something. What's the spill with the Star, the seven of swords, and watching shit go down? Yeah, bestie. Collective, so this is probably not your energy. This could be your bestie energy. So just be mindful of that, collective. Your bestie could be going through this. Or collective, this is your ex-lover or your ex-spouse. And y'all used to be besties. So, collective, your ex could say, come on now, let's let bygones be bygones. Let's agree to disagree. I drink to you on it. Let's go out to eat. Let's get along for the kids. Let's do this. Let's do that. And it's like, collective, you don't want to hear nothing about your ex saying, remember when we was besties? Collective, you don't want to hear it. Or something like that. So, somebody could be trying to get you to reminisce about the good times. Somebody wants you to, like, not suspect that they're coming up against you or something. Or collective, this could be going on with your bestie. Your bestie could be in danger. One who is always by your side, who never ditches you, and who would take a bullet for you. So collective, somebody could be lying to you, or it could be your bestie that could be in danger. Give me the spill with the bugaboo strategy and number 28, the anchor. The sixth house. What someone does routinely, their responsibilities, their skills and training, their employment, their job. So somebody wanted a specific career for a reason. Or somebody wanted you, collective, because of your career for a reason. Somebody wanted somebody's sixth house for a reason, or somebody wanted to fulfill their sixth house for a reason. So somebody wanted to obtain a specific type of employment for a reason, or somebody was using somebody else's employment for a reason. But it was for, like, to do somebody harm or to cause a betrayal. So somebody was using the sixth house to cause a betrayal. What someone does routinely, their responsibilities, their skills and training, their employment. So collective, somebody could have also been abusing their position of leadership or authority. Collective, somebody could have been doing something to you. Somebody was in a position of authority or whatever their job is, and they was like falsifying documents. A journal, somebody's falsifying documents or something. And they're doing it at work. Or somebody could be a skilled, somebody works in the dark web and they're very skilled at it or something. Or somebody's very skilled at falsifying documents or something. Yeah, something like that. So give me the scoop with the Ten of Swords, the Magician, Police, and Jealous. Excuse me. Yeah, breaking point. Things are becoming too much to bear. Who is that calling? I'll answer that later. Breaking point. Things are becoming too much to bear. Yeah. Somebody crazy. I already said that. Yeah. Somebody could be growing impatient. Somebody is going crazy. So it's like collective, somebody wanted to do harm to somebody tonight, but something might force this person to wait. And it's like they going crazy because they can't wait or they didn't want to wait. Because somebody jealous. Or collective, somebody wanted to offend you so bad that they're going to end up offending themselves. Like before they get to you. Somebody crazy. Like I said, this could be somebody sitting outside waiting to do a murder suicide. And this person got tired of waiting and just gonna blow their own head off or something like that. This is crazy. Because somebody didn't want to wait or somebody was growing impatient. Or somebody doing something to themselves. Because they being sneaky and doing something they ain't got no business. Somebody got to be fake. Somebody got to be phony. This is also somebody's lover. Somebody got to pretend that they love someone. They want to get married. They want to stay. This is becoming too much for this person. Because they got to lie to get something fraudulently or something. What's the scoop with the Knight of Cups, the Eight of Wands, stand center, and distorted masculine? So somebody might have an outburst too. Someone may get kicked out of the house. Yeah. Yep. Somebody's trying to stay center and keep their cool. But because somebody is a distorted masculine, somebody gonna do something. And somebody might get kicked out. Or collective, somebody want revenge on you because you kicked them out or your bestie kicked them out or something like that. Or somebody wants to move back in or something. That's the scoop. The Knight of Cups got to stay centered because they're really a distorted masculine. So the Knight of Cups is trying to hide their distortedness so it won't be obvious or something. Because the Knight of Cups know that if they behave like a karmic collective, you're going to kick them out or something. Or they're going to blow their cover and their plan is not going to work or something like that. What's the scoop with the Star, the Seven of Swords, watching shit go down and bestie? Or collective, somebody was trying to get inside your event. Or something. The family dynamic may be toxic. So this could definitely be baby daddy, baby mama drama. Somebody could be going through a divorce. But collective, you have kids by this person. Somebody really, this is somebody planning on doing harm to the other parent because they want full control of the child. Or they don't want to pay somebody child support or alimony or something like that. Or somebody's ex is in love with somebody else. So collective, be careful because it's like your ex is willing to do harm to you because they want your new lover or they want your bestie or something. Or something like that. The family dynamic may be toxic. Collective, your lover could be planning to do you harm because they want your bestie or they want your new lover. And collective, your ex could be gay or lesbian or something. This is crazy. Or collective, it could be two people. It could be your so-called bestie and like this distorted masculine coming up against you or something. What's the scoop with strategy, bugaboo, the sixth house, and number 28, the anchor? Yeah, stubborn. Someone is very stuck in their ways. Yeah, collective, this is somebody that don't want to leave you alone. Or this person feels as though you offended them. Somebody want revenge. Or collective, somebody lying on you. And they were saying you a bugaboo, but it's not you. It's them. Or collective, this person always lie. This person lie all the time. This stubborn energy. This person, that's what I'm picking up with this. I don't know why. But I'm picking up this person lie all the time. They could be a pathological liar. Or this person is a liar. Or they have to lie to offend someone. They have to lie. They got to be fake and phony. They got to smile in your face, collective, to offend you or something like that. Someone is very stuck in their ways. Tell me more about this stubborn person. Tell me more about this stubborn person. Collective, the stubborn person might block communication with you. Or collective, you're going to block this stubborn person. And that could be the reason why this betrayal is going to reverse. So collective, this stubborn person wants your access to get denied. Somebody want to do something on private property or something. Somebody want to cause a robbery, a store invasion, or like a home invasion, or a death on somebody's property. Collective, somebody probably wants your business to get shut down or something. They want to do a crime on your property or your business or something. So I said, tell me about this stubborn person. So collective, you could have blocked this stubborn person. Their access to you is denied. Or collective, this person is trying to deny your access to something. Oh boy. Then we got guarded. Very guarded and protective over heart. Yeah. Collective, I think for some of y'all know this person crazy. Or something. Collective, this could be somebody you're not going to let inside your party. Or you don't let this person on your property or something. It could also be a conflict of interest. Yeah, same shit, different day. Yeah. Somebody do something like every day. The same shit, different day. This person. Somebody's stubborn. They don't want to change. And it's the same shit, different day with this person. So this could be a stalker or something. Or collective, this is a hacker. Or like a, this is somebody that fished the dark web or something. Yeah. So collective, I'm picking up somebody that's stalking you, hacking you, fishing on the dark web. Collective, this person has like physical access to you. So it's like collective, when this person can't get you through hacking or fishing, it's like this person live around the corner. They got physical access to you. Or something like that. What's the tea with the Ten of Swords in reverse, the Magician, Police, Jealous, and Breaker Point? Love on the brain, yeah. Dreaming, fantasizing, daydreaming, nostalgic. Yeah, so for some of y'all, this is an ex. This is a deranged ex. This person is out of control. Yeah. What's the tea with the Knight of Cups, Eight of Wands, Distorted Masculine, Kicked Out, and Staying Centered? And I'm gonna end it because, yeah, wants you back. mm-hmm. So collective, somebody wants to do you harm, but collective, I think I heard they don't have a chance in hell. Collective, somebody either was planning your demise be in the past and it didn't work, or collective, they was planning your demise and they didn't finish. Either something didn't work or they wasn't able to finish. And collective, somebody wants you back so this person can finish. They want to finish. What's the tea with watching shit go down, join the gossip? Bestie, the Star, Seven of Swords, and toxic family. Yeah, legal issues. Yeah. Somebody wanted to cause you legal issues, collective. Somebody wanted to give you karma that you didn't deserve. Or collective, somebody might go to jail after dark hours tonight. Somebody that was trying to offend you. Somebody wanted to cause you legal issues. Or collective, this person gonna end up with legal issues. And this toxic family, collective, this is your ex, or it could be like a family member or something. Or it's your bestie's family or something like that. Collective, I also see, a crime scene. And collective, you was hanging out with your bestie, and after you left, that's when your bestie is going to get offended. It was after you left. I see that too. But it's like collective, I also see in the cards that this person couldn't wait. So it's like collective, you left in the nick of time because this person was getting ready to offend you and your bestie. But you got up and left. Or something like that. Or collective, it was two people coming up against you and they gonna turn on each other. Or collective, you was with your bestie. You was hanging out with your bestie and somebody's ex or something was planning on doing them harm. And collective, this person waited for you to leave. And when you left, that's when this person is gonna offend your bestie. Or something like that. Collective, this could be your bestie's spouse. And collective, your bestie's spouse could have forbidden you to come to their house because they were saying you was a bugaboo. But collective, your bestie's spouse just didn't want you around because they was no good. So this bugaboo energy could have been a tactic to keep you away or something. So collective, I don't know. This could be your bestie's toxic family, collective. But collective, if this is your bestie, I don't think you would be sitting there enjoying the gossip. Or somebody is really not somebody's friend. Or something. Collective, your bestie could be your toxic family. I don't know. Or something like that. Excuse me. And then fake accounts. Fake social media accounts to spy. Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Collective, this could have been your best friend that was coming up against you. Or collective, your bestie had a crush on you or something. Or collective, your bestie liked it, your lover or something. Or collective, your bestie wanted to take custody of your children. Somebody crazy. Collective, somebody could have wanted to do harm to you to be with your lover and like raise your children or something crazy like that. Or it was two best friends, collective, that it could have been coming up against you or something. Something like that going on. This is custody of children or somebody wanted somebody's lover or something. Because somebody jealous of somebody. Or somebody wanted somebody's artist or somebody's music or something. Give me the scoop about this bestie. Give me the scoop about this bestie. Show more gratitude. Collective, your bestie could have got hurt for taking up for you too. Collective, your bestie might get hurt for taking up for you. Because your bestie was showing you gratitude. So, collective, this could be your bestie's spouse. It's like, collective, your bestie and their spouse might get into it. Your bestie, my husband, might come home and say, who you was on the phone with? And your bestie going to say, I was on the phone with the collective. And her husband going to say, didn't I tell you to stop talking to the collective? And your bestie going to say, I was just calling the collective to say hi or to thank her for her success that she had earlier today, to encourage her or something. And it's like, collective, your bestie's spouse might do harm to your bestie. Like, they're going to, like, snap or something? And it's like, collective, this person, it could be an Aquarius, don't have to be, or this person is conceited, or they're a narcissist. It's like, collective, once somebody do harm to your bestie, they're gonna watch the shit go down and enjoy the gossip. So, collective, your bestie's offender hates you. This person don't like you. That's why your bestie got hurt. Because this person don't like you. So, collective, I also see your bestie's offender is going to offend your bestie, and then they're going to come look for you. Or something like that. This man probably tired of y'all because y'all best friends or something. This man going to snap. Yeah, it's like he going to do harm to your bestie, and then he coming to look for you, collective. Or something. Collective, your bestie's spouse could have been trying to get you arrested, get a restraining order on you, telling you to stay away from the house, stop calling his wife, stay away, stay away, stay away. And somebody might snap, collective, so just be careful or something. Because it's like, collective, this man had a plan and you was messing it up. It's like this man wanted to marry your bestie for like money or something. And collective, be careful because you could be intuitive. And this man didn't want you around because he know you intuitive or something. And he was telling your bestie to stay away from you. And she wouldn't listen or something. Like something crazy or something like that. Or it's like, collective, your bestie's spouse didn't want your bestie. Your bestie's spouse wanted you or something. Whew. Collective, your best friend's spouse or your best friend's offender was telling your best friend that you're harassing them. Yeah, this person was telling your bestie something about you that wasn't true. So your bestie would stay away from you, collective. So collective, if this is your best friend's lover or her husband, he was telling your bestie that you was trying to sleep with him or you was flirting with him or something like that. Or something. So collective, just be careful. Because if your bestie spouse do harm to your bestie, collective, I see this man coming for you. He coming to look for you too. But collective, he might not be able to get to you and he might like kill himself like outside your house or outside your a building or something because he got tired of waiting on you. And this man know he in trouble because he just left from doing harm to your bestie. Or he couldn't get past security. Collective, I don't know if you work for the police or something. Yeah, somebody gonna do harm to somebody and collective, this person was coming for you. Or something like that. So collective, just be careful. Or collective, your ex could have got a new lover. And it's like, collective, your ex is a distorted masculine, and he might do harm to his new lover. Or something like that, collective. Your ex could be a little crazy. Because he wanted to come back to you or something. It's a man out here that didn't like somebody like that. It's a man that he didn't like this woman like that. So, collective, this man didn't like you like that. Or, collective, this is your ex. This distorted masculine is your ex. And he didn't like his new lover like that. And he might do harm to her. And then try to come to you, collective. And you're not aware that he done did harm to his new lover or something. Oh, boy. So, collective, one of your exes, I see, to be careful, because one of your exes might put you in a situation. He need an alibi or something, because this man done did harm to somebody, and he trying to come in your energy or something. So, collective, just be careful of that. You're going to find out your ex done did something, and then they showed up at your house like ain't nothing happened. Or something, but I'm going to end it. Or collective, somebody, a narcissist. It's like collective, somebody is in your energy because they done did a crime. This person not in your energy because you're inspiring. It's like this person in trouble. So collective, somebody could be coming in your energy and say, oh, I want to read your book, or I want tickets to your show. I want to know what you doing. I'm interested in you. What's up with you? But it's like collective, this person on the run or something like that going on. Or something. Or collective, somebody gonna show up at your job after their hours tonight, and this person wanna use you for an alibi. And collective, be careful, because you might lose your job. So, this is Blood Queen Tarot. My phone about to die. Please don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and or share. And collective, enjoy the night, and thanks.